grateful to have the opportunity this day to be here, to share in thy spirit, to celebrate the birth of thy Savior this Christmas season. We are grateful that we have the opportunity to hear this here at this time, or from afar, as we have the technology these days to spread this word throughout the world. Please bless those who are here this day, that they might feel thy spirit in their hearts and take that home with them, that they might find joy in their journey in life, and they might be uplifted by the words and the songs that are given this day. Bless those who present, whether through word or song, that their hearts might be filled, that they might do the best that they can to emulate the power of the Spirit, that it will be able to touch us and make us feel gratitude for our blessings and for being here this day and partaking in this experience. Bless us all with the things we need in our lives, that we may be able to help and serve others who are in need, and be mindful of those who struggle, and be there for them when they are in need. We're grateful for these blessings we have in our lives, and we say this in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Brothers and sisters, Merry Christmas. I am really excited for this fireside. It's something I've looked forward to all year. And we have such immense talent in the North Star community. So I'm looking forward to being able to feel the spirit of the music and the talents and abilities that are about to be shared. I am grateful to those of you who have spent long hours in the choir and practicing and rehearsing, as well as those who are sharing individual musical numbers tonight. And a special thanks to the Fireside Committee for making this possible for us who aren't gathered there in the Provo Library to participate this evening. I'm gathered here with friends in Kansas City, and we're looking forward to this evening, just like so many other North Star friends around the world who are participating via live stream. When I was asked to share a few spoken words and thoughts this evening about Christmas, I had a couple of thoughts. One is obviously news of my musical inability has reached the Fireside Committee, and it's apparent that I am in the running for the position of the Lloyd Newell of North Star. If you don't know who Lloyd Newell is, you can turn and ask your neighbor. I'm sure there's someone who is familiar with him. But again, really excited about this evening and this Christmas season altogether. The theme of this fireside is What Sweeter Music, and that comes from a selection that will be performed by the choir tonight. And I wanted to just share a quick line from that. What sweeter music can we bring than a carol for to sing, the birth of this, our heavenly King? And it is obviously at this time that we celebrate the birth of our Savior Jesus Christ, and the special significance that Christmas has in our lives as Christians. As I've thought about what that means, I reflected on something President Eyring said a few days ago in the First Presidency Christmas broadcast, when he said, "There comes a feeling of love into our hearts that makes us want to give and to be gentle as we remember whose birth we celebrate." And as I thought about that in this spirit of love, combined with the theme of the fireside tonight, I thought, what carol can we sing? It doesn't just mean that we have to sing on someone's doorstep, but there are things that we can do to sweeten someone's Christmas season, to lighten their load and to bear their burdens and to help them feel joy. It also reminded me of the church's theme for this year, the initiative Light the World. Obviously, that comes from remembering our Savior is the light of the world, but what can we do as followers of Jesus Christ to light the world this Christmas season? So the reason I like that so much is that it evokes a feeling of action, that there's something we can do individually to bring light to the world in small and simple ways. There are so many things we can do. It could be something as simple as calling or texting a friend that we haven't spoken to, or visiting someone who might be lonely, inviting someone to dinner or to go to serve others. there are many opportunities for us to express the love that we feel for our Savior Jesus Christ by reaching out and serving others. And it doesn't have to be in a grandiose way, but sometimes, most times, it's the small things that we do to brighten others' lives that is most significant and helps us to feel the love of our Savior for ourselves. I know that's true for me when I serve others, that it puts my needs second and puts others first, and then that does bring me great joy. So my challenge for myself this evening, and I would invite all of you as well, as we listen to the music and pay attention to the feelings that we have in our hearts, I'm sure that names will come to our mind of someone who might need some light from us, that we can do something to sweeten this Christmas time for them. And as we do so, that the Lord will fill our hearts with even more light. I'm grateful for the gospel of Jesus Christ. I'm grateful to know that I have a Savior that loves me and a Heavenly Father who knows me. And He knows all of us. He knows the things that we experience in life. He knows the abilities that we have to become more like Him. And I'm thankful for that. I'm especially grateful and would be remiss if I didn't mention how grateful I am for this community. All of you that I've had the opportunity to meet or have noticed the things that you do to serve others in this North Star community have really taught me so much in the past couple of years about what it means to be a disciple of Jesus Christ and to look inward for ways that I too can reach out to those who need something to sweeten their life. And I just want to say thank you for that. And again, Merry Christmas. I am so thankful and excited for this opportunity to be together tonight. And I say this in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Brothers and sisters,
I hold this tiny hand in mine. These hands will cause the blind to see and bless the children one by one as they gather round his knee. These tiny feet so soft and
he will die, but he will live. Proclaim. Oh, Infant holy, infant lowly, for his bed a cattle stall. Oxen lowing, little knowing, Christ the babe is Lord of all. Swift are winging, angels singing, Noel's ringing, tidings bringing, Christ the babe is Lord of all. Christ the babe is Lord of all. Flocks were sleeping, shepherds keeping vigil till the morning saw the glory, heard the story, tidings of a gospel true. Thus rejoicing, free from sorrow, praises voicing, greet the morrow. Christ the babe was born for you. Christ the babe was born for you.
As was similarly pointed out earlier, I also am lacking in that musical talent, so I get to use words. I hope you have felt the spirit here. I hope you have found peace. I hope you have found hope. I hope you have found community. I failed to make one very important recognition as I was looking over the program. There's one name I think that might be on there more than any other name, and that is Brandon. Where are you, Brandon? If you would stand up for us, please. A round of applause for Brandon. Thank you. Not only has he been incredibly crucial to tonight's program in providing accompaniment and other pieces, he also has been very involved with the planning of this meeting. I didn't know this, but apparently we're not only streaming to those locations live, we are streaming live in general. I was receiving a few text messages from Spencer Thompson reminding me to do a few things better. So I will try and, Spencer, this is for you. In all sincerity, the North Star Conference is one of the most unique and unparalleled meetings that I have had, conferences rather, that I have had the opportunity to attend. There is a spirit of Christ there that is incredibly profound. The sense of the Spirit, the sense of atonement, is extremely palpable. If you have other plans, we understand. If those plans can be changed, I would. And with that, hopefully Spencer will be satisfied. Brothers and sisters, and it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And this taxing was first made when Syrian was the governor of Syria. And all went to be taxed, every one into his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee out to the city of Nazareth, into Judea, under the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her newborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. I think that last song that we heard, as well as all of them, reflect that silence, that stillness. And we still sing today about that silent night. But brothers and sisters, there's another version of the Christmas story. It's what the author John Eldridge likes to call a behind-the-scenes peek of what's happening. And it is anything but a silent night. John the Beloved in Revelation writes, "And there appeared a great wonder in heaven, a woman clothed with the sun and the moon under her feet, and upon her head a crown of 12 stars. She, being great with child, cried, travailing in birth, and pained to be delivered. And there appeared another wonder in heaven, and behold, a great red dragon, having 7 heads and 10 horns and 7 crowns upon his heads. And his tail drew a third part of the stars of the heaven and did cast them to the earth. And the dragon stood before the woman, who was ready to be delivered, for to devour her child as soon as he was born. And she brought forth a man-child who would rule all nations with a rod of iron, and her child was caught up under the throne of God. And the woman fled into the wilderness, and there was a war in heaven. Michael and his angels fought against the dragon, and the dragon fought and his angels and prevailed not." And prevailed not. "Neither was their place found any more in heaven. And the great dragon was cast out, the old serpent called the devil and Satan, who deceived the whole world, was cast out to the earth. And I heard a loud voice saying," and this is important, "Now is come salvation and strength and the kingdom of our God and the power of his Christ. For the accuser of our brethren is cast down, which accused them before our God day and night. And they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony. And they loved not their lives unto the death." Brothers and sisters, Christ came. He came to comfort us. He came to perform a perfect atonement. He came to be able to give us all that we need from him. And he also came to defeat the ultimate enemy. This was no silent night. This was a D-Day invasion. This was God sending his beloved and precious only begotten Son into the very seat of the adversary's domain. Not as a God, not as the Lord of hosts and the captains of our captain of armies, but as a baby. And Jesus wins. And because of that, we all can win if we choose him and his path. Returning to the manger. "And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in their field, keeping watch over their flocks by night. And lo, an angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them. And they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord." And I share that with you in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Brothers and sisters, we have two more and I forgot my announcement sheet. Linnell, if you'll hand that to me. We have a closing number, and then a closing hymn, if I can find it. Closing hymn will be Silent Night, sung by the choir and congregation. and accompanied by Susan Carey on the flute. After that, we will have a closing prayer from Greg Hammerquist. Thank you.
Our dear Heavenly Father, we thank Thee for this day. We thank Thee that we're able to be here together as brothers and sisters in Christ. And we ask Thee to help us to remember at this Christmas season the true meaning of Christmas and the coming of Thy birth, of Thy Son. We ask Thee to help us to keep that spirit with us as we go throughout our lives. We say these things in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.